Chris Farkas, Chief Operating Officer, Hillsborough County Public Schools. Here to read for Black History Month. Excited to read a story called Trombone Shorty. Trombone Shorty was written by Troy Andrews. Who is Trombone Shorty? It's his true story about how he came up in Treme, one of the poorest areas in New Orleans. We open up with the character of him, Troy Andrews. Where you at? Where you at? We have our own way of talking and living down here in New Orleans, and our own way of going about what we do. And that's what we like to say. We want to tell you, friend, where you at? Lots of kids have nicknames, but I want to tell you the story of how I got mine. Just like when you listen to your favorite song, let's start at the beginning, because this is a story that's about music. But before you can understand how much music means to me, you have to know how important it is to my hometown, my greatest inspiration. I grew up in a neighborhood in New Orleans called Treme. Anytime that day or night, you could hear music floating in the air. And there was music in my house too. My big brother James played the trumpet so loud you could hear it halfway across the town. He was the leader of his own band, and my friends would pretend to be in that band with him. "Follow me," James would say. There's one time every year that's more exciting than any other, Mardi Gras. Parades fill the streets, and beaded necklaces are thrown in the air to all through the crowd. I love the brass bands with their own trumpets, trombones, saxophones, and the biggest brass instrument of them all, the tuba, which rested all over the musician's head like an elephant's tuba. "Where you at? Where you at?" the musicians would call. All day long, I could see brass bands parade by my house while my neighbors danced along. I love these parades during Mardi Gras, because they made everyone forget about the troubles they had from our own little town. People didn't have a lot of money in Treme, but they always had a lot of music. I listened to all these sounds and mixed them together, just like how we make our own food. We take one big pot, we throw in the sausage, the crab, the shrimp, the chicken, the vegetables, and the rice, whatever's in the kitchen, and stir it all together and let it cook. When it's done, it's the most delicious taste you've ever tried. We call it gumbo, and that's what I wanted my music to sound like. Different styles combining to create one musical genre, gumbo. But first, I needed an instrument. The great thing about music is that you don't even need to have a real instrument to play. So my friends and I decided to make our own. We might have sounded different from the real brass bands, but we felt the greatest musicians of Treme. We were making music, and that's all that mattered. Then one day, I found a broken trombone that looked too beaten up to make any music at all. It didn't sound perfect, but finally, with a real instrument in my hand, I was ready to play. The next time the parade went by my house, I grabbed that trombone and headed out in the streets. My brother James noticed me playing along and smiled proudly. "Trombone Shorty," he called out, because the instrument was twice my size. "Where you at?" From that day on, everyone called me Trombone Shorty. I took the trombone everywhere I went and never stopped playing. I was so small, sometimes I fell right over to the ground because it was so heavy, but I always got right back up and learned how to hold it up high. I listened to my brother play songs over and over, and I taught myself those songs too. I practiced day and night, and sometimes I fell asleep with that trombone in my hand. One day, my mom surprised me with tickets to the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival, the best and biggest music festival in town. We went to see Bo Diddley, who my mom said was one of the most important musicians of all time. As I watched him on stage, I raised my trombone to my lips and started to play along. He stopped his band in the middle of a song and said, "Who's that playing out there?" Everyone started pointing, but Bo Diddley couldn't see me because I was the smallest one in the place. So my mom held me up in the air and said, "That's my son, Trombone Shorty." He said, "Well, Trombone Shorty, come up here and play." The crowd passed me overhead till I was standing on stage with Bo Diddley himself. I walked right up to the microphone and held my trombone high up there, ready to blow. "What do you want to play?" Bo Diddley asked. "Follow me," I said. After I played with Bo Diddley, I knew I was ready to have my own band. I got my friends together. We called ourselves the 5 o'clock band because that was the time we went out to play each day after finishing our homework. We played all around New Orleans. I practiced and practiced, and soon my brother James asked me to join his band. When people wondered who the kid in this band was, he proudly said, "That's my little brother. That's my brother, Trombone Shorty. Where you at?" And now I have my own band called the Trombone Shorty in Orleans Avenue, named after a street in Treme. I played all around the world, but I always love to come back to New Orleans. And when I'm home, I make sure to keep my eyes on the young musicians in town and help them out, just like my brother did for me. Today I play the same New Orleans Jazz Festival where I once played with Bo Diddley. And when the performance ends, I led a parade of musicians around, just like I used to do in the streets of Treme with my friends. Where yet? Where yet? I still keep my trombone in my hands, and I will never let it go. As I said, this is a true story. We get to see some real pictures. This was really Troy Andrews, Trombone Shorty, when he started. That's Bo Diddley. It's a true story. It talks about perseverance. It talks about overcoming odds. But the most important thing is being yourself and staying true to your passion. So I'm honored to read this book to you during Black History Month, and honored to be here for Hillsborough County Public Schools. Thank you.